Hello and welcome to the Abbey Stadium for a huge match. It all comes down to this, of course. This is the second leg of the Premiership Grand Final. Swindon, they are going on a track walk with the boss, of course, Alan Rossiter. And there is the trophy that either Jason Doyle or Danny King will be lifting aloft this evening. The Premiership trophy 2019 got both sets of ribbons, of course, but Swindon very much in the driving seat following their excellent 8-point victory at Vauxhall a couple of nights ago. There are the Ipswich True Plant Witches coming on their track walk together with Richie Hawkins. Before the meeting, we spoke with some of the people involved this evening.
Well, Rasmus Jensen, grand final time here at the Abbey Stadium this evening. A terrific performance, first and foremost, on Tuesday at Ipswich to come here with an 8-point lead tonight.
Yeah, I think it was a great result for us. We won there one of the times we were there, and then we lost the other time, and then we won this time. So that's one we can take to here, and 8 points, not too bad, but still not over.
Yeah, for Ipswich, their last few visits here have been very mixed. I think they lost by two very early on in the season. The last visit here, the Robins won by over 40 points. So certainly a strange old situation. But nevertheless, Ipswich have got a strong and capable side.
Yeah, for sure. And they had a few team changes, which probably benefit Ipswich. But we'll see. It's a tough one to call. But I think the 8 points lead will do us a big advantage. And that's a bit of a cushion we have. So
You've obviously made a big difference in the engine room of the Swindon side as well. You were rewarded for your early season form with Glasgow and seem to have really enjoyed yourself here as well.
Yeah, the track suits me like pretty perfect. It's a big, nice track, and that suits me pretty good. So, yeah, I love racing here and, yeah, enjoying it.
We've seen a lot of it as well on camera and behind the scenes as well. The team atmosphere, the camaraderie between these riders here at Swindon as well. And it could work out that's going to be a positive recipe for success.
Yeah, everyone gets on like near enough perfect in the pits, and everybody's just having a big laugh before, during and after the race. And there's nobody who doesn't like each other or have a bit of an issue with each other. So I think it's just a perfect way of having a team spirit.
And just finally, what would it mean for you to get your hands on a Premiership gold medal this evening?
Oh, it'd mean a lot. Obviously, it's my first season in the Elite League, so it'd be awesome to do a double. I did a triple with Workington in the lower league last year, so the year after and do a double, that'd be pretty cool.
Well, we wish you all the best tonight.
Thank you.
Well, Ipswich reserve Jake Allen, second leg here at the Abbey Stadium this evening. Just a quick reflection on Tuesday night. Obviously, to lose the home leg by 8 points, never ideal.
No, mate, you know, it's obviously not ideal to lose at home in any circumstances. So we're a little bit disappointed with that. But, you know, just come in here tonight and try and make a good start. And it's Speedway, so anything can happen.
Yeah, anything can happen, like you say. Important that you don't go in with a defeatist mindset either, and I think that's definitely been the message from Richie this evening.
Yeah, mate, you know, we turned over a 10-point deflect from Poole. We know we're at home when we turned him over, but we've run Swindon twice close here this year and then got blown out of the water the other time. So hopefully we can start well tonight and make a good match of it.
You mentioned how you were blown out the water by 40 points or so, I think, last time you were here. Nevertheless, team changes have been made, and obviously having the experience and skill of Niels Christian Everson at number one could and hopefully make a big difference tonight.
Yeah, mate, you know, we're all well aware that we got hammered here the last time we were here, but, you know, there's seven guys at the end of the day against seven of our guys, so hopefully we can do the business tonight. And like you said before, it's Niels' first time here this year on the new track. But, you know, it's not too different to how it used to ride. So hopefully he should be on the ball from the get-go.
And obviously the position you're in at the team as well, if you can have a good night, that could also have a big say at the Witches end up as well.
Yeah, mate, you know, both semi-finals I scored double figures and then scored pay double figures on Tuesday. So hopefully I can keep the good form going from my playoffs and, you know, hopefully get a big payday tonight and help the team.
Yeah, and just finally, obviously, regardless of what happens here tonight, first season back in the top flight for Ipswich, and it's going to be reflected on as a positive one overall.
Yeah, definitely, mate. You know, we're all written off at the start of the year, like they all do with the guys and their pens and paper, but, you know, what do they know? We had seven hungry guys battling for every point, and, you know, we picked up a lot of points on the road, and also we're at the top of the table at one point of the year, you know. So hopefully can I take a lot of positives out of this season, from whatever happens tonight and start off next season even stronger.
Many thanks for your time. Wish you all the best, Jake.
All right, cheers, mate.
Well, Ellis Perks, grand final time here at Swindon this evening. Great to be coming here with some form of advantage, and 8 points, certainly a handy one as well.
Yeah, definitely. Ipswich are a tough team, and it was a tough match on Tuesday, but like you say, it was handy to come away with that 8 point cushion, and hopefully we can just get off to the start we had last week and finish the job early.
This really is a great team that Swindon have got here this year, isn't it?
Yeah, it's definitely great, you know, with the likes of Troy and Doyle, who have done a lot of laps around here, and then backing them up with Adam Ellis and Rasmus Jensen, it's a real strong team, and me and Klaus in reserve, we're doing our job, so it's solid all the way through, and that's it. We just need another solid night's performance from everybody.
And you've got to be confident of having a solid performance from the whole team as well, obviously. Putting Wolves to one side like you did last week as well, with the strength they've got, obviously unbeaten here at the Abbey Stadium this season as well, so plenty of reason to be hopeful.
Yeah, definitely, we can be confident, but we've got to stay humble. There's still 15 heats of Speedway to go, and 1-5-1 to them throws it, you know, the other way, but as long as we do our job and, like I say, keep our unbeaten record here going, I don't see why we can't have another good night like we did against Wolves and finish the job.
Individually, you've got to be more than happy with the way you've rode for the Robins in the top flight.
Yeah, it's been a great year. You know, coming in later during the season, they made me feel welcome straight away, and it only took me a couple of meetings to get used to the track, and it's been really good. You know, the guys have been great helping me, and it's a fantastic position to be in.
2019 is always going to be a year you look back fondly on as well. Obviously, took some terrific steps back in the right direction. Last night, obviously, more or less got one hand on a National League gold medal, it looks like, with a big win for the Leicester Lion Cubs over Kent. Hopefully get a Premiership one tonight, and then two big meetings coming up for Leicester in the Championship against Glasgow on Friday and Saturday.
Yeah, just hearing you say it sounds busy. It is. It's been the busiest week of my career. And like you say, one of the best, if not the best, you know. We trained hard and prepared hard during the winter to put ourselves in good position. But if you'd asked me at the start of the season if I thought we was going to be in the running for three league titles, I would have told you not a chance. But here we are, you know. Like you say, we had a good night last night at Leicester with a 28-point lead going into Monday's leg for the National League title. And then again tonight, we've got an 8-point lead going into the Premiership title. And then we've got tomorrow at Glasgow and Saturday at Leicester. We could probably say we're favourites, but it's going to be tough. But it's like you say, it's a great position to be in, and I'm really looking forward to it.
And so you should. They say hard work pays off, and fingers crossed it does for you. All the best for tonight, Ed.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
Well, Chris Harris, grand final time here at Swindon. Obviously, a far from ideal situation coming in 8 points down, but nevertheless, got to get off to a quick start here tonight.
Yeah, obviously, a bit disappointed to lose at home last, well, Tuesday, whenever it was. But yeah, it is what it is. You know, Swindon's been a solid side pretty much all season, especially this second half of the season. And yeah, we just need to up our game tonight.
Like you say, at points it's been about a lack of consistency for the Witches, but when everyone does fire, this really is a solid team.
Yeah, we got a good 1-7 ourselves, so it should be an exciting match. We just don't want to let them, the Swindon boys, get away early on. So if we can hit them hard to start off with and hopefully get their heads dropped, then anything's possible, but it's going to be a tough task tonight.
Yeah, nevertheless, obviously with the experience that you've got, obviously Neil's coming in, Danny as well, and like you say, the exciting progress of Jake Allen and Cameron Heaps, positives to build on and take into tonight as well.
Yeah, obviously I've done a few of these now over the years, and yeah, obviously with Neil's coming, the experience he's got, you know, for Heat 1 is ideal, especially against Jason, because obviously he's on fire at the minute, so if we can hopefully lower their colours, then we'll go from there.
Yeah, we've spoken to Jake Allen as well, and Richie Hawkins and Chris Lewy have been vocal about it. Great to see a club like Ipswich back in the top flight. The attendances have grown as well, and it's been a positive campaign overall for the Witches.
Yeah, it's good that they're back in the top. You know, it's where they belong, really. You know, they're a club that should be in the top flight, and hopefully we can get a few more up there as well.
We will see. Wish you all the best for tonight, Chris.
Cheers.
Well, good to hear from the Bomber and the other riders involved here this evening, as the crowd were absolutely massive crowd has turned up here at the Abbey Stadium, and well, what a great sight that is to see these playoffs. Of course, well, they always do generate huge crowds when we come to the grand final, and that's exactly what we've got here tonight. The fans, well, they're still pouring into the stadium. There is the Legends Lounge, of course. where some of the ex-riders, ex-Robin stars will be this evening, as the crowd look on, and the trophy just being shown off there. As you can see, here come the two teams, starting with the Ipswich True Pump, which is quite a few Ipswich fans have made the journey here, even though they did go down to that heavy defeat on Tuesday by 8 points at home. Fans that young and old, of course, great sight to see, isn't it? The youngsters, three generations, of course, there's Grandad, and what a great family sport, as we all know, of course, Speedway is, as the fans applaud the riders coming out. We just saw the Witches, and here come the Swindon SFS Filtration Robins. And we'll quickly give you the two teams for Ipswich. Niels Christian Everson is at one, Danny King two, Richard Lawson three, Chris Harris four, Cameron Heaps five, Jake Allen six, James Sargent at seven. Richie Hawkins has changed his septet around somewhat for Swindon. We're there as they were on Tuesday. Jason Doyle, Adam Ellis, Tobias Muselek, Rams Musienson, Troy Batchelor, Ellis Perks, and Klaus Vissin. That's how the two teams line up here tonight. The riders, they're now out for heat number one then, and Swindon, they really are big favourites to take their third crown in the last 9 years, or 7 years, I think it is. Plenty of Ipswich fans here on the back straight. Of course, the Witches, the Robins were victorious in 2012 on a brilliant night. If you was a Robin supporter, many of these are, of course, down at Poole, of course, that was. And then what a tremendous victory it was just 2 years ago, where they came from on the back of a home defeat here against Wolverhampton to stun the Wolves up at Monmore to take the crown. Of course, the Swindon, they did win away in the first leg of this meeting. It's going to be a massive effort if Ipswich can overcome that. They need a good start, and they've not got one, because Niels Christian Everson, he has gone into the tapes, and Christina Turnbull, well, no doubt that will be a disqualification for Niels. So the Ipswich number one, the worst possible start that he and his team could have got off to, brought into the side to bolster their chances to make the playoffs, of course, which they certainly did. But Niels, wow, that is a dreadful start for him. A little bit twitchy there with the Fink clutch hand. And indeed, there's confirmation that Niels has been disqualified. So we have got a revised lineup, because Richie Hawkins, he's decided 50 metres back, even for the seven-times Danish champion, is just too much early on here this evening. So Jake Allen, the very much informed Ipswich reserve, he comes in to take the place of their number one. So the revised lineup, it is King off one, Adam Ellis off two, Jake Allen now off three, Jason Doyle off gate number four. A dreadful start for Ipswich, but can they do something out of the start into that first bend? Well, it's a good start by Jake Allen. He's made a tremendous start, and so has Danny King. So the Witches were there on a 5-1, but here comes Doyle up the inside. He's moved through in the second place, and now he's challenging Jake Allen. But it is Jake Allen that leads away, and here comes Doyle. Ruthless move there, boy. Doyle got very close to the inside line, but it is he that leads away from Jake Allen, getting an unexpected ride in heat number one. He's in second place. In third spot is Danny King. Adam Ellis, he's at the back. Ellis, he rode very well at Foxhall a couple of nights ago. Paid nine was his total from his four rides. But it looks like he's going to be finishing at the back here in heat number one. His teammate Jason Doyle is, though, who leads the way. Doyle, he was excluded in heat number one on Tuesday when he took a tumble, and a bit of a up and down night for Doyle, but he did recover well from that. He finished with 11 points. Of course, it was Adam, but unfortunately run over his leg in the staging of heat number one after Jason had fallen. Adam could not avoid him, but thankfully he was okay and was able to continue in the meeting, and he's certainly okay here this evening, as the huge crowd down the back straight applaud their iconic number one, Jason Doyle, coming through on the inside of Danny King battle of the two captains, and then on the inside of Jake Allen taking a reserve ride here as Swindon, they get a 3-all in heat number one. They lead 52-44 on aggregate. Heat number two, well, we've been given a bit of extra time, of course, or Jake Allen has rather, because he's out for two rides on the trot, of course. The lineup, we've got Ellis Perks off gate number one. He's had a tremendous season for Swindon since he came into the side. And not everyone is keen on the Speedway action here tonight. The youngsters there on the back straight, oh, I think they're coming up now to take a look at the reserves race. So it is Perks off gate number one. Jake Allen, gate number two. He showed up well in his first race where he led Doyle for a lap or so. Gate number three sees Klaus Wissing. He was disappointed with his return on Tuesday at Foxhill, and he got paid two. Ellis scored 5 points. It is Wissing off three, and James Sargent, it is, who comes out off gate number four. Sargent has found points tough to come by in this Premiership. Heat number two gets underway and into the first bend as they come towards us, and it is the two Swindon reserves who lead the way. It is Ellis Perks out in front, but in fact Jake Allen now has got through in the first place as Perks has had engine failure whilst he was leading the way, but his race is run. He's pulled onto the infield. It is Allen then that leads the way from Wissing in second place. James Sargent is back in third. Looks like he's going to pick up a point in this one, so he doesn't he hasn't scored too many points for Ipswich. Came into the side in a late season switch as they released Edward Kennett to bring in Niels Christian Everson, and also had to make the switch at reserves. James Sargent coming in as well, and it certainly did work to a degree because they have made it through to the grand final after that stunning two-leg victory over the former champions, of course, of last year, the Poole Pirates. As Jake Allen, well, he wins heat number two. Second place goes to Klaus Wissing. The Witches fans down the back straight, will they be delighted with that? Because it does mean that Ipswich, will they take the lead on the night by 7 points to five? And on aggregate, well, that lead has been cut to just 6 points. It would be a huge shock if Ipswich were able to come over to overcome that 8 point deficit. But stranger things have happened. As Jake Allen came through to take the win, Wissing second, Sargent third, Ellis Perks having that machinery issue which stopped him from scoring any points in that one. The Witches lead on the night, Swindon six up on aggregate. Heat number three, next one up we have Richard Lawson. He comes out off of gate number one. He's been a solid performer for Ipswich this year. So the Witches very much an in-depth side this year, so a lot of people were tip them to perhaps collect the wooden spoon this year. They've certainly not done that. They could be collecting the Premiership trophy. Heat number three then. Lawson off one, Jensen off two, Chris Harris off three, Muselek off gate number four. The race is underway, and in fact Christina Turnbull, where she has put the red lights on immediately, and I think it's for that rider in your picture, Tobias Muselek. He's going to get a warning, just made it jump the start somewhat. And indeed, Tobias, he has been moved for that movement, so he'll have to stay still for the rest of, well, not just this race, of course, the rest of the meeting as well. It does carry forward. Tobias, well, he rode very well on Tuesday, top scored, in fact, for Swindon with paid 13 from his five rides. Showing some great late-season form is the pole. Heat number three as they come towards us into that first bend. It's a good start by Music again and by Rasmus Jensen with Chris Harris in pursuit. He's making a move on the outside of Jensen. Richard Lawson is at the back. Here comes Bomber around the outside. Heroics he performed last year, of course, for the Poole Pirates. But he's moved through in the second place in heat number three. It is Muselek then who leads the way. Here comes Harris on the inside of Tobias. Muselek just looking over his shoulder, saw the danger, and he's accelerated there, and he's leading Harris at the moment. Jensen back in third, although he's not that far behind the Bomber, with Richard Lawson tailed off in this one. Here comes Razza on the inside of Chris, and he's got through in the second place. So it's a 5-1-4 Swindon. The Abbey Roar will be going up full volume here as it stays like this. It is Muselek that leads away from Rasmus Jensen in second place. Chris Harris looks like he's only going to get a point in third. Nothing for Lawson. as the Abbey roar sounds. It is a 5-1 for the home side then in heat number three, as Muselek and Jensen, who formed such a great partnership in the main engine room of the Swindon team, they score a massive 5-1 in heat number three, with Tobias getting the victory. Harris, well, he got through in the second place ahead of Jensen, but Raza, well, he was not to be outdone. He found a way back past Chris on the inside to set up a 5-1 for the home side, and it does mean that Swindon move into the lead on the night to 10 points to 8. More importantly, on aggregate, they extend that lead. They're now out in front by 10 points. Overall, 59 points to 49. Super riding there from Tobias and from Rasmus. Heat number four, next one up. The riders out on track. We've got a change. In fact, as Richie Hawkins doing all he can to stem the tide. Jake Allen comes out replacing James Sargent in this one. Not only stem the tide, of course, maybe even get to Ipswich back on level terms or even in front. It is Allen off one, Klaus Fishing off two, Cameron Heats off three, Troy Batcher off four. The race is underway. And into their first turn, it is Jake Allen who leads once again. He really has got his gating head on tonight, isn't he? Jake, he's out in front from Troy Batchelor, now coming around the outside of Allen into second place, and now he's challenging. It's the two Australians out in front, and it's Batchelor who's moved through in the first place ahead of Allen in second place. Fixing is in third. Cameron Heaps, he's struggling at the back in this one. He's had a super season with Ipswich and also with Edinburgh in the Championship, but he's tailed off in this one. Heat number four, is Klaus Fishing. Well, now he's put in the Jake Allen under a lot of pressure and almost found a way through there. Very close indeed. We've seen some good action early on. The track is absolutely superb. We had so much wet weather, but it's holding up very well indeed. The track staff have done a marvellous job, not only to get this meeting on and in such great condition, but all season, of course, having started the year a little bit late because they put the new track down, and it's won universal praise. As Troy Batchelor, well, he wins heat number four in thrilling style. He takes the victory. Second place goes to Jake Allen. Third spot to Klaus Fissing. Cameron Heaps at the back. The Robins, well, they now open up a 4-point lead on the night, 14 points to 10. And now they're 12 points up on aggregate. Of course, 90 points is the magic mark. If they can get there, then 91 rather, the title will be theirs. As Troy celebrates his victory in heat number four, the Robins just extending that lead a little bit more. Heat number five, next one up, of course, Swindon. Well, they've already got one trophy in the cabinet. They won the Supporters Cup, Premiership Supporters Cup against Bellevue a few weeks ago over the two legs, winning the second leg here. And of course, this will be the first time for many, many years. I think they've done it once in their history, but many years ago, that they're going to win, they could possibly win the league title in front of their home fans. In 2012, they won it down at Wimborne Road in front of a few Paul supporters that were still there, of course, but also at Wolves on an epic night 2 years ago when they overcame a first leg loss here at the Abbey Stadium to stun the Wolves management, riders and fans. And just 2 years later, they're possibly going to do the double for the first time in their history. That would be quite superb, wouldn't it? Heat number five, the lineup. We have got Tobias Muselek coming out of gate number one. Won his first ride in great style. Gate number two sees Danny King, only got a point in his first ride. Gate number three sees Rasmus Jensen, Nils Christian Eriksen off gate four, of course, who touched the tape in the first outing. He's not made a good start in the heat number five. It's the two Robins once again then. It is Jensen that leads the way from Muselek in second place. Everson has got through in the third. Danny King is at the back. So it's all Swindon at the moment. Ipswich haven't taken an early 2-point lead after a couple of races, but it looks as if they could fall 8 points behind on the night and a massive 16 points behind on aggregate. As Rasmus Jensen leads the way, of course, Raza, well, he's hoping for double glory this year. He also rides for Glasgow in the Championship, and they will be facing Leicester over two legs to decide the Championship winners for 2019, so a could be a trophy-laden season for Raza as they go down the back straight for the final time. It is Jensen that leads the way with Tobias in second place. It's going to be the second 5-1 for Swindon and the second 5-1 for this pairing as the Robins fans are delighted. It is Jensen that takes that one from Muzelek, just swapping places from heat number three, but it's still the end result. It's a 5-1 to Swindon. Third place goes to Everson. Terrible start for him. Danny King, nothing at the back. So Swindon, well, they could almost feel that the trophy is coming home, back home to the Abbey Stadium after a year away. Just look at the crowd there. Absolutely brilliant scenes here at Swindon. Jensen, Muzelek, Everson, King. That's the finishing order of heat number five. 19 points to 11 on the night, 68 points to 52 on aggregate, and a stunning 5-1 there from the two Robins. There were the Witches fans there, not really going their way this evening at the moment. They started off well. Yeah, well, he doesn't feel the cold, does he? We move on to heat number six. And, can these riders warm that gentleman up? Cameron Heaps comes out off gate number one and Jake Allen off gate number three. Allen's been the pick of the Witches so far. Gate number two, that's his Jason Doyle. He's been the pick of the Premiership in 2019, hasn't he? Top of the averages. And Troy Batchelor, of course, well, he has finished second in the averages. So what a top two for the Robins, and they could be leading the Wiltshire side to glory here tonight. Adam Ellis comes out off at gate number four, didn't score in his first ride, but he has formed a very, very good partnership with Doyley this year, riding at that difficult number two position. Heat number six gets underway into that first bend, and it is Allen who's made another great start, and he leads the way. Here comes Jason Doyle on the inside. He's got through in the second place, but it is Jake Allen once again who's held in front. He's been very impressive this evening as the informed reserve. It is Allen then that leads the way. Here comes Doyle on the inside. I think he's got a little bit too much speed for the Ipswich reserve. He has indeed. Allen tries to come back on the inside, cracking action in heat number six. We've seen some brilliant racing here this year. A track superbly prepared by Ronnie Russell and his track team once again tonight, as Adam Ellis, well, now he's got through in the second place, and it's another 5-1 for the Robins then, as Jason leads away from Adam in second place. Jake Allen having got off to a good start, he's only back in third. It's all Swindon at the moment. This is going to be their third 5-1 in the last four races. The crowd are cheering them on down the back straight as Doyle and Ellis, they've had plenty of 5-1s this season, and there's another one. Jason takes the win, Adam second, a point for Jake Allen. And the Abbey Roar sounds out again down the home straight, and I'm sure we're going to get one down the back straight as well, as the crowd acknowledge Jason and Adam. Jake Allen, it was, who made the best start, and he was leading the way, but then Doyle, well, he found a way past his fellow countrymen. And then it was Adam Ellis who also managed to get around the outside of Jake. Super entertaining riding in heat number six. And it does mean that the SFS Filtration Robins, they now move into a 12-point lead on the night and 20-point lead on aggregate. Heat number seven, riders out on track. This one, it sees Troy Batchelor coming out of gate number one. Pretty comfortable victory for him in his first ride. Gate number two, that sees Richard Lawson. He finishes at the back in his first outing. Gate number three, that sees Ellis Perks, who had that engine failure in his first ride. And from the outside, it is Chris Harris, who battled hard, as he always does, of course. He only got a point, though, in his first outing. So the Swindon management and fans will be very, very happy the way the first half of this meeting is going. The Robins at 20 points up on aggregate. Is there any way back for the men from Suffolk? Heat number 7, then Batchelor off 1, Lawson off 2, Perks off 3, Harris on the outside, Green Knights on, Christina Turnbull releases the tape into that first bend. Who's releasing touch the fastest? Well, it is Batchelor from the inside. He leads the way from Chris Harris coming around the outside of Ellis Perks, but Perks is showing good form. He's back in third place. He's holding off Richard Lawson at the moment. It's another heat advantage for the Wiltshire side then, as Batch leads away from Harris in second place. Ellis Perks, what a fairy tale season it's been for him. Of course, he's hunting titles in all three divisions, not only for Swindon, of course, but also for the Leicester Lions in the Championship and also the Leicester Lion Cubs in the National Development League. He could end up as a three-time winner this year. That would be quite, quite superb for a rider who was almost lost to the sport a couple of years ago. Perks back in third place in this one. It is Troy Batchelor who leads the way. Classy, classy rider as Troy, and has been for many years. Of course, he did have a foray into the Grand Prix series for a couple of years. He won the Grand Prix. He won one Grand Prix, didn't he, of course, and was quite superb in some of the meetings, but didn't quite work out for him. But it's worked out for him in heat number 7. Fans young and old are absolutely delighted as the Batch pulls a wheelie. 2 wins out of 2 for him. Harris second, Perks third. Nothing there for Richard Lawson. Hasn't scored from his first 2 rides. Swindon, well, they move into a 14-point lead now on the night. Look at those scenes. And now lead by a massive 22 points on aggregate, 77 to 55. As Troy remains unbeaten after his first 2 outings. The same as Doyley, of course. And also Muselik and Jensen, well, they're unbeaten by which? Next one up, heat number 8, around about the halfway stage of this second leg of this Premiership Grand Final, and it's certainly going the way of the home side here tonight. Klaus Vissin, he comes out of gate number 1. Gate number 2, Jake Allen, another reserves change by Richie Hawkins. Gate number 3 sees Adam Ellis, got that thrilling Pate win in his last ride from the outside. Danny King has only scored Pate 2 so far. Heat 8 is underway into that first bend. Ellis off gate number 2 has made a good start against a former British champion and Ipswich captain Danny King, who's in second place. King trying to get through on the inside, but Ellis holds him at bay. In third spot it is Klaus Vissin with Jake Allen. Well, having performed some heroics in the early races with 9 points from his 4 rides. He is, we've had 8 points from his 4 rides. He's at the back in this one. It is Adam Ellis, though, who leads the way from King in second place. Klaus Vissin is back in third. He's done very well since he's come into the Swindon side. Of course, they made a couple of changes. Did the Robins as Vissin, just as we say that, he almost loses control there. Jay Cannon had to shut off. It is another 4-2 for the Robins. This will be their third of the meeting. And it will see them extend that lead on the night to 16. And well, it'll be 24 points up on aggregate. They'll be thinking about when they can win the trophy pretty soon. As Adam Ellis wins heat number 8. Second place goes to King. Third spot to Vissin. Had a bit of a moment there, but held off Jake Allen. Another heat advantage for the home side. Then it's been all Swindon since heat number 3. They have had 3-5-1s and 3-4-2s after Ipswich had taken an early lead. But that's a distant memory now, because they're trailing by 16 points on the night and 24 points on aggregate as Ellis wins his first race of the evening. Coming round to celebrate, so Klaus Vissin, he's having a better night than he did at Foxhall Stadium a couple of nights ago, where he only scored Pate 2. He was very disappointed with that performance, but doing better here this evening. So there's just so many people here at the Abbey Stadium. Great, great atmosphere we've got tonight. This is what people come out to Speedway for, evenings like tonight. And if you are a Swindon fan, you will be absolutely delighted. Heat number 9, next one up. And this one sees the very potent pairing of Tobias Muslick and Rasmus Jensen coming out for Swindon. Doesn't get to much easier for Ipswich, does it? Ah, well, that was the day when gentlemen like him used to wear their hats with all their badges, of course, and he's still got his, as you can see. Great to see. One of the old long-time supporters of British Speedway. So we've got Muslick, Jensen, Heaps, James Sargent taking the place of Jake Allen in this one. The race is underway and it's all Swindon once again. It is Muslick and it is Jensen who lead the way. Razzarell in front. Tobias in second place. In third spot, it is James Sargent. Cameron Heaps coming around the outside. The Witches, well, they're just not getting off the starts tonight, are they? And if they do, they're very easily passed. It really has been all Swindon so far this evening. Jake Allen, will he win heat number two? But that's the only race winner for the True Plant Witches this evening, as Tobias and Razza lead the way. Jensen out in first place. It's going to be 3-5-1s from this pairing. They're both going to be unbeaten by a Ipswich rider, as are Troy and Jason, of course. They had a massive win over Wolves in the second leg of the semi-final here. They've been racking up some huge home wins over the last couple of months of the season, have the Robins, and I think they're going to get another massive win here tonight, as the home fans, more reasons to be cheerful. It's another 5-1 for the Robins, and well, they're almost home and hose. They've now moved into a 20-point lead on the night and 28-point lead on aggregate. They're on the 86 points. Ipswich on 58. It's still mathematically possible for the Witches to overturn this deficit, but in reality, it's not going to happen. So Ipswich, or sorry, so Swindon, well, they could wrap it up mathematically in the very next race. They've got a certain Jason Doyle and Adam Ellis out. Can they do it in heat number 10? Tobias and Razza have certainly been doing it in heat 9 and all evening. So heat number 10, is this going to be the one when Swindon claim their third Premiership title in 9 short years? The lineup, we have got Adam Ellis off gate number 1, won his last ride. Chris Harris off gate number 2. 3 points from his first two so far. Jason Doyle unbeaten. He's off gate number 3. If ever you want a man to win a race, you've got that's the man to have. Jason Doyle, top of the Premiership averages. Richard Lawson off gate 4. Is this going to be the race where Swindon are crowned the champions? It could well be, because Adam Ellis isn't leads the way. Richard Lawson on the outside, as Jason Doyle has got through the inside of Ellis. It is a 5-1 for this pairing. They got one in heat number 6. And they could be getting one in heat number 10, which will lift the title for the SFS Filtration Robins of Swindon. It is Adam Ellis who is out in front. Jason Doyle quite content to stay in second place. Harris and Lawson just fighting for the odd point. It's not going to be anywhere near enough at Swindon. Well, they have been totally dominant over the two legs against the Witches. They ran out very comfortable victories at Foxhall by 8 points, and they're going to be very comfortable victors here this evening, and they are going to be crowned the champions. It really has been a great effort all round, not only from the riders, of course, also the management, the promotion, and the track staff, who prepared a superb track surface each and every week, as Adam Ellis and Jason Doyle, will they seal the victory in heat number 10 over Chris Harris and Richard Lawson. The Swindon SFS Filtration Robins, they are the 2019 Premiership champions, and well, that's quite magnificent scenes here at the Abbey Stadium. The first time in many, many years that they've ever won the title in front of their home fans, and it's a unique evening for them, and well, the fans, there's been plenty here to witness this occasion. And it's well, it's great to see. So we've had the Abbey Roar all year. This year it's built to a crescendo, and tonight the Robins have taken the title. Many congratulations to them, and well, all hugs, and well, with Roscoe, be a few tears as well, maybe even be the odd kiss. and also of course Lee Kilby, who's part of the promotional team now. His dad, of course, what a legend he was. Great to see Lee down there as well. But well done to Swindon. Commiseration to Ipswich. They gave it their all, but they were just outclassed, really, in the final over the two legs. But they finished second in the Premiership table. No one would have given them hope of that. They've done that quite superbly, but not quite as good as the Swindon Robins. And, well, the... It's going to be given out the result now by Dave Rowe. There you go, Adam Ellis, Jason Doyle, Chris Harris, Richard Lawson. That is the result of heat number 10. As Roscoe getting his interview, of course, with BT Sport, who are here this evening alongside as well as our good selves. And the fans are just being given the official confirmation. And well, oh, well, there is Lee Kilby, son of course of Kilb. And great scenes they are. As the Queen music sounds over the PA system. Lee, he is absolutely Swindon through and through, of course. And well, great scenes. Isn't that great, isn't it? Lee there just shaking hands with Michael Hunt, of course, the clerk of the course, and also, of course, Lee's son. Great, great scenes. Well, it's back to track action now. Heat number 11. We've still got five races to run before we can have the presentation of the trophy. Then the riders out for this one. We have got Niels Christian Everson. He will be gutted with the way his performance has been this evening. Just at 1 point from his two rides. Gate number two, Troy Batchelor. Gate number three, Danny King. Ellis Perks on the outside. The race is underway as they come towards us. Well, it is Batchelor, it is Everson, though, who's made the best start from the inside. He leads the way. Oh, there's problems there as Troy Batchelor went out a bit wide, and Danny King, well, he had to lay his machine down. And, well, Christina Turnbull, she hasn't had many decisions to make, but we can see there that Batchelor, he just locked up ever so slightly. And I think that it could well be a disqualification for the Swindon Star. And, well, in fact, indeed it is. The Witches fans, well, they've got a little bit of cheer about. They're only being held against one rider in Heat 11. So, Batchelor, he couldn't really argue too much with that. Of course, Christina, she's got the benefit of the replays provided by BT. And it was pretty clear-cut that Troy was the cause of that stoppage. So he is out. Ellis Perks by himself against Everson and Danny King. Can the Witches get their second heat advantage, or second race winner of the night, and their second heat advantage it would be, of course, as the race gets underway. And it is Everson from the inside who's made a good start. Ellis Perks coming around the outside, though, of Danny King. And he's managing to split the two true plant Witches as Everson leads the way. But here comes Perks now on the inside, and he almost got through into first place, but Everson just too much experience there. And in fact, Danny King, well, now he has come down, and well, the race, I think it could well be stopped, even though Everson is leading. Danny, well, he cannot get off the track in time, and the red lights have had to come on, and King, well, he will be gutted with that. He just made an error going into that turn, and indeed the yellow exclusion light has come on. And well, I'm not sure if they were far enough into the race to award the result. It could well be a third staging of heat number 11, and indeed that is the case. King has been disqualified, and we will be going with a third attempt at heat 11. So basically we've got a match race then between Perks and Everson. Niels, well, he was leading both times that the race was stopped. Will he do so again? Heat number 11's third attempt, it's underway, and it is Niels that's out in front from Ellis Perks in second place. Perks making a move again around the outside of Niels, but the seven times Danish champion won it 7 years in a row, equaled the wins of the great Ollie Olsen, the great Dane, main Dane Ollie Olsen, to win seven domestic titles. That really is some achievement. Of course, Scott Nichols, who's here tonight working for BT Sport, he's also won seven British championships, although they were not in a row. It was quite a feat by Niels to equal Ollie's magnificent record. Kenneth Pierre, it was, who won the title this year as Everson went for win number eight to get the new record, but it was not to be. But it looks like it will be a win for Niels in heat number 11. This will be only the second race victory for an Ipswich rider. It will give them a 3-2 heat advantage, with only two riders going to finish this race then. Niels wins it. Second place goes to Ellis Perks, who just had a few wobbles there at the end of the race. The Ipswich fans, there's a very small reason for them to be cheerful. They have provided a race winner. Applause there for their number one. After 11 races, Ipswich move on. Oh, sorry, Swindon move on to 41. Ipswich on to 21. On aggregate, it's 93-62. Heat number 12, next one up, we have got Jake Allen off gate number one, the pick of the witches so far. Gate number two, that sees Tobias Muselek, where he's been one of the picks of the Robins. He's unbeaten by an Ipswich rider, sorry. He's off gate number two. Richard Lawson has struggled tonight. He hasn't scored from his three rides. He retired in his last outing. Of course, the race where the Robins won the title. He's off at gate number three, and Klaus Vissin, he comes out off at gate number four. So heat number 12, just four races to go of the 2019 season here at the Abbey, and it is Jake Allen. We've been very impressed with his starting prowess this evening. He leads heat number 12. Here comes Muselek on the inside of Jake and Tobias. Well, he's got through in the first place. He wants to finish off with a paid maximum here tonight. You can be sure of that. He's leading heat number 12 from Allen in second place. Klaus Vissin more competitive tonight than he was at Vauxhall two evenings ago. He's back in third with Richard Lawson. He's at the back once again. Looks like it's going to be a pointless return for Richard. He's just close enough, and if he can make a challenge on Vissin, out in front though, it's Muselek that leads away. He's on his way to plate 12 from his four rides. Could well be seeing him out in heat number 15 as well. Vissin, well, he's going out wider and wider, trying to find the speed to challenge Jake Allen, but Allen holding him off at the moment, riding that inside line with Lawson. He's nipping round at Vissing's exhaust pipe at the back. It is going to be a 4-2, is it, for Swindon? Muselek wins it, coming from the back. Jake Allen second, Vissin battled hard, got a point for his efforts in third. Nothing there for Richard Lawson. It really has been one-way traffic here tonight in the main, as Tobias, that's another victory for him. Two paid victories this evening. And out of the start, it was Jake Allen that made best gate. He's made some brilliant starts this evening. He led the way, but Muselek, well, he knows the fast parts of this circuit. The Robins, of course, getting used to the track earlier this year. And more cheer there for Tobias, from the fans for Tobias. A 4-2 for the Robins. And the lead now 48 points to 23 on the night, 97 points to 64 on aggregate. Three races remain. Heat number 13, next one up, and we always look forward to this one. We've got Jason Doyle coming out of gate number one, Niels Christian Everson off gate number two, Troy Batcher is off gate number three, of course excluding his last ride, heat nine, and heat number 11, and off gate number four, it is Cameron Heaps, who's another rider that struggled tonight. the experimentation of moving the Ipswich riders round. Not really worked out for Richie Hawkins, but I don't think anything they would have done would have worked out. So fans, young and old here this evening, they will be able to tell their kids and grandkids we were there the night that Swindon won in front of their home fans in the 2019 Premiership. The lineup then, so it is Dorloff, gate number one, unbeaten by an opponent so far. Everson off gate number two, won his last ride. Gate number three, Troy Batchelor, two wins in that exclusion. From the outside, Cameron Heaps, who's just scored 1 point, that was in his last ride. Heat number 13, riders taking their time. No threat of rain, thank goodness. Well, what a wet wet month of October it's been, and September as well, towards the end. Heat 13 gets underway. Jason Doyle is at leads the way, and he's been joined by Troy Batchelor. The top two riders in the Premiership averages are in first and second. They've had many a 5-1 this year, as have Jason and Troy, and they look like they're going to get another one here over Everson in third, with Cameron Heaps a bit outclassed in this one. Not surprisingly, three former and current Grand Prix riders in front of him, and of course a former world champion, Jason Doyle, of course, who won the title a couple of years ago, and he'll be hunting to get that back again. He's been a brilliant last couple of weeks for Jason. Of course, he retained his place in the world championship after the last round at Torren, and then the next day he went out and retained the Czech Golden Helmet on his birthday, would you believe. So it really has been a golden Indian summer for Jason, and he's going to lift the Premiership trophy for the Robins this evening, as Troy Batchelor, he wins heat number 13, Jason Doyle gets a paid win, third spot goes to Niels Christian Everson, nothing there for Cameron Heap. So Doyle, well, he's still on a paid maximum. I wonder if we'll see him in the heat number 15. 53 points to 24 the lead now. Swindon smash through the three figure mark, they move on to 102. Ipswich on 65. It really has been David against Goliath this evening, or over the two legs in fact, as the riders come round. Double wheelie celebration from them, the home fans being entertained evermore. Heat number 14, next one up, this one. It sees Chris Harris coming out of gate number one. Ellis Perks is off gate number two. James Sargent's got to take his third ride, so he comes out in this one. He's off gate number three. And Rasmus Jensen, he's another Swindon rider, unbeaten by an opponent. He comes out off gate number four. So we've got Jason, Tobias and... Jason and Tobias who are unbeaten by an Ipswich rider so far, and can Raza join them as well? He's off at gate number four. We've got a very famous guest of honour to present the trophy this evening, and Eddie Kidd, of course, the former stuntman. It's great to see Eddie's got a great love of Speedway as the race gets underway, and in fact, the bomber there just anticipated the start somewhat, or in fact, in main fact, been James Sargent. Sarge really is known as sometimes getting a bit of a flyer, and I think he may well have done there in heat number 14. And well, indeed, James has been warned for moving at the start. So second attempt at heat number 14 then. Jensen, Perks, Harris, Sargent. Green lights on, the riders coming out towards us. And into that first turn it is Rasmus Jensen, who's made a great start off gate number four. He leads the way, so it looks like he's going to get a four ride paid maximum. Could see him in heat 15 as well, as they come around to complete the opening lap then. It is Jensen that leads the way. Perks is challenging Chris Harris for second place. Good action between those two riders. Sargent is at the back again. It is Jensen though that leads the way from Ennis. Perks coming through on the inside of Chris Harris. Harris answers him back on the outside. So we've had some good at Speedway action tonight, and it's continuing here in heat number 14. So massive amount of credit must go to the track staff, led of course by Ronnie Russell, brother of Terry. Of course, Terry unfortunately not here tonight, the chairman of Swindon Speedway. He's laid up lower following a back surgery operation, but I'm sure he's watching from the comfort of his sofa. and I'm sure he's enjoying what he's seen this evening as his side are going to, oh, they have lift the title as Rasmus Jensen, he lifts heat number 14. Second place goes to Chris Harris, third spot to Ellis Perks. Some good action there between Bomber and Ellis. Another heat advantage for Swindon. It's a 4-2. They move into a 57-26 lead on the night. And on aggregate, they are in front by 106 to 67. Harris having to work hard to get up into second place. As the crowd, well, they've certainly been able to keep their hands warm this evening. It's not, in fact, it's quite a mild night for mid-October. But so certainly have plenty of cheering to do as Razak comes round to celebrate with the fans. Four ride paid maximum for him, so I wonder if he'll come out and heat number 15. And well, James Sargent, he had a bit of engine problems there, and well, that's great to see camaraderie after heat number 14. Just tells you everything about Speedway, really, doesn't it? Super shot there of Razak giving James a lift back to the pits. The songs are coming out, and well, no doubt we're having quite a few more after the or during the presentation in a very few moments' time. And indeed it is, hi-ho, silver lining. Super, super stuff there. So heat number 15, the lineup. We have got off gate number one, it is Tobias Muslek, unbeaten by which. Off gate number two is Chris Harris. Gate number three sees Jason Doyle. He comes out off gate number three. He's also unbeaten by an Ipswich rider. We've changed positions to our secondary camera. And... taking a look from the back off bend number four. So you've just got 20 seconds to go. We're about ready to go. Jake Allen comes out off gate number four for his seventh ride. Been the pick of the witches. Heat number 15 gets underway into that first turn. And it is music and it is Doyle who lead the way from Jake Allen in third place. Chris Harris missed out at the start. He is at the back as Jason Doyle is that leads the way. So, oh, Jason going out very, very wide indeed and almost clipping the air fence there. He's thrilling the crowd in his last ride. He's going out very wide indeed. He really is giving a masterclass here in the final race, the final track action of 2019, of course, here at the Abbey. And what a season it has been for Swindon. They've won the double, of course, having lifted the Supporters' Cup. And now they're going to lift the Premiership trophy very, very soon indeed. And that rider in your picture, Jason Doyle, he will be holding it aloft, the captain of Swindon. He leads going into the final lap. Muslek in second, Jake Allen in third. The final action of the 2019 season here at Swindon then, it's going to result in a big 5-1 for the Witches and paid maximum for Tobias and Jason. So just caps off a perfect night for the Wiltshire side. And I'm sure we're going to see some brilliant scenes. Now the track action has come to an end as at Swindon, well, they win here tonight by a massive 62 points to 27 on the night, and by 111 to 68 points on aggregate. So well, there was only one team in it, wasn't there, over the two legs. Absolutely incredible two-leg victory for the Robins. 8 points they were victorious at Foxhall 48 hours ago, and they've won here this evening by a massive 35 points as Tobias and Jason are still basking in the applause. And Tobias there are just doing a bit of a burnout. Jason coming round on his lap of honour. So great scenes here at Swindon. Yeah, well, I'm sure there's going to be a few sore heads in the morning. I'm sure there'll be quite a bit of celebration going on tonight, not only amongst the riders and management, of course, also the fans. Might indulge in the odd alcoholic beverage to toast the success of the Swindon SFS Filtration Robins, the 2019 Premiership Champions. Well, we said Eddie Kidd was going to present the trophy this evening, and there he is. And acknowledging the crowd. What a superb motorcyclist he was back in the day. Used to thrill the crowds. And he's some of the riders that have been thrilling the crowds this evening. The Swindon Robins on the parade vehicle. The Witches riders are going to come out as well for their medals. And well, no one has left the stadium. Everyone's waiting for the presentation of the trophy and fireworks as well. I'm sure we'll be getting those. Terry, he always has a superb firework display at the end of a successful season, and that's exactly what tonight has been, as the Robins come round once again, having done the full circuit of the track. So great scenes here at the Abbey. Roscoe obviously out there on the parade vehicle as well. Doesn't shun the limelight, does he? As plenty of handshakes there be going on now. And let's go down and join Clive Fisher, the centre green presenter here, who's going to lead the two teams to the presentations to Eddie. And then it'll be the trophy to Jason Doyle.
Come on.
Well, that was superb, wasn't it? A fantastic firework display to finish off as the champions, well, they will be amongst the crowd shortly. The huge throng that are under the main stand, there they are, look at them. No one has left at the stadium. And, well, just in fact, before that, I think the riders, well, that's a nice touch. They're going to go over to the fans. There's a, well, there's quite a few fans that still over the back straight, and well, that's a great sight, that is, as they're going to go over and celebrate with their fans. Massive part of the sport, of course, Speedway supporters. We wouldn't be here without them, would we? Superb scenes there, and then they'll be coming over, no doubt, to the main, under the main stand. And now let's go and join Ryan, who's going to bring some reaction to the action.
Well, it's been a terrific performance from the Swindon CFS Filtration Robins here in the second leg, resulting in a 62-27 at second leg scoreline, and a stunning 111-68 on aggregate. And nobody can argue with the end result. It looked a bit dodgy at one stage this season with the Swindon Robins, and it looked as though the Wolverhampton Wolves were battling for the final playoff place, but things suddenly changed and the Swindon Robins gathered that momentum and they secure a league and cup double. It has been a terrific achievement, and building to the league success in 2017 as well. Jason Doyle, Adam Ellis, Tobias Muschelak, they were all members of that team 2 years ago, and Troy Batchelor enjoying success earlier in the decade as well. And Adam Ellis, he's had some really strong performances. Klaus Vissing came in partway through the season. He's used his experience to help him come with some crucial points. Rasmus Jensen, what a signing he was mid-season. Really added even more strength to the engine room of the team. We know the quality that Jason Doyle has got, the 2017 world champion, and he seems to have inspired everyone here. Troy Batchelor, he's been reliable as well. Tobias Muschelak really loving himself here at the Abbey Stadium, and Ellis Perks as well. Might not have always got the points he deserves, but nevertheless, plenty of tremendous battling efforts.
Then I get back on. And really is celebration time here at the Abbey Stadium. And like I say, it's been a thrilling Premiership chase, one of the most keenly contested run-ins to the playoffs. And as I said, Swindon were looking a bit iffy at one stage whether they'd get in, but they have built on their dominance here at the Abbey Stadium, where they have been unbeaten in 2019. And it was a stunning performance to beat Wolverhampton Wolves the way they did a week ago, and even stronger tonight against the Ipswich, which is realistically the job was probably done on a Tuesday night with a terrific effort at the Foxhall Stadium to win by 8 points. And they did it in fine style, sealed the deal this evening.
Winning this. Does that mean you got an open top bus as well, Oscar?
And donning the t-shirts, the Swindon CFS Filtration Robins, as it says, double champions. And it was a great meeting against the Bellevue Aces not so long back, as they claim the aggregate victory over them here. And they could only dream of a double, unheard of in these parts of the world. But it's been a terrific team effort. The crowd has grew week on week as well, and the supporters have well and truly played their part. And as we mentioned, Jason Dahl, the skipper, back after a year away with Somerset, and he has inspired everyone around the place. Alan Rossiter, another league trophy to the cabinet.
Yep, it's pretty special, especially in front of this amazing fans tonight. Pretty special. I know the first one was good, but this one's pretty special too.
Yeah, really done it in fine style. What a team performance against Ipswich tonight.
Yeah, no, the boys done absolutely fantastic. So really proud of them all. So it was amazing, and I couldn't keep the bubble, you know. You had to be, you know, gracious and that, but I always felt we were strong enough to win this.
Yeah, for the club, obviously, it's a massive achievement. It's another top flight title for yourself as well, and no one is ever more special than another, and you can see your emotion again here this evening.
Well, that's just the way I am, you know, but I'm just proud of all these boys, so fingers crossed we're going to have some more next year.
Fingers crossed. We'll let you go and celebrate. Cheers, with the supporters.
Well, many thanks to Roscoe there, and also thanks to Ryan for conducting that interview. And now let's join some more celebrations with Clive.
Go, we are winning it. I see us, Swedish. a great night for Swindon Speedway, that's it, Sean.
It's amazing to do the double, and you know, this is for you guys, this is not for us, so thanks for being here, and let's have some fun.
It's Roscoe's second for Swindon, that is wild, isn't it?
Oh, he's already been crying.
Shall we march on, ladies and gents? Let's have a few rooms on, and it's going to be a great night tonight. Send that to my crew.
It's been awesome, mate. It's great to be part of a club where, you know, from the management to down to the fans, everyone wants success. So we've had an awesome team this year, probably the best team I've been involved with, and best way to top off a good season.
And for you personally, a good year as well.
Yeah, it's been awesome, but like, it's the others, the guys around us and the teams around us make the years good. So this year's been awesome, and now hopefully they change the rules so we can stay the same 7 for next year.
Wouldn't we like that?
I hope
you'll tonight. How's the manager
station,
Jens? Ladies and gentlemen, Rasmus Jensen, ladies and gentlemen. Got a funny feeling, Rasmus, they actually want you.
Maybe, I hope so.
Can you fit similar how you feel tonight? Can you similar how you feel at this moment?
Yeah, it's so awesome being a part of this, and I did the triple with Wiggins last year, and then a league up this year, we do the double, how more can you want?
That's what it's all about. I've also got to tell you, I've been voted the rider of the night tonight as well.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
So if you'd like to go get your award, there it is. Ladies and gentlemen! I know it's a repetition of the questions, Ennis, but what does this mean to you tonight?
It's unreal. No, firstly, title number one, and it's going to be the greatest club that I've ever been in for. It's been a really big week, you know, we've got two more titles to go for this week, but this is the main one, and I'm really happy to have done this with such a great team, and I really hope to have back next season.
Okay, we like him back too. That is for excellence, everyone, thank you. Thanks for listening, ladies and gentlemen. Close. When you came and joined us and Roscoe gave you that call, did you ever expect this tonight?
No, you know, I spoke to Roscoe on the phone and he said, if you want to come to a winner team, this is it. And I had no doubt, you know, I just wanted to race more, and I'm so glad I came to this club, and your fans have been awesome, man.
Sum up how you feel tonight, because you've been in Speedway a few years. How do you sum up tonight?
Yeah, it's just been a great night, you know. It's just really been a great night. All the boys did a hard work on Tuesday, and then come here tonight, and we just did what we had to do. So, fuck, it's so a bloody great team.
Thanks for listening, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, the man that's captained the side to victory tonight, I give you your very captain, Jason Doyle. Well. Jason, many, many congratulations. You've achieved a lot in your career. How did you sum up tonight?
Hey, that just sent shivers down my spine. That's unbelievable. Thank you. But by far, I just said to Roscoe, this beats 2017 and 2012 titles, because we're hands down the best team all season. And what a crowd tonight to win it on home soil. This means a lot to us guys, and this is what we ride Speedway for.
And for you personally, what a great season for you.
Yeah, it's a lot of people seeing the Grand Prix side to all the results, but also the league racing was going so good, and it was always nice to come back to Swindon and on a winning team was always great. So thank you very much to all the supporters, and we love you guys.
Thank you, David. Jason Doyle. where is he? Where's Roscoe? Where's Roscoe? Alan Rossiter, ladies and gentlemen. Well, you asked for the Blends and Roar to be back, and you certainly got that tonight.
We certainly did. Thank you very much, everybody.
I know it's going to be an emotional night for everybody concerned with Swindon Speedway, the Cup and Dub League double, first time ever it's been achieved. What's your thoughts?
I'm just so proud of these boys. We had to make a change. We didn't. It was forced upon us, the changes, and the changes we made were for the better. But the team spirit, the camaraderie, these boys are absolutely amazing, and I tip my hat to them because they're the guys that did it. Like, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make him drink it. They're the ones who did it.
And we look forward now to a winter of interesting topics going on at the VSBA conference.
Yeah, obviously the news of Paul this week, they're going to drop down, but I think there's, that's a shame, eh? We love beating Paul, don't they? Yeah! Oh, well, we'll just have to fight everybody else again.
Anyway, enjoy the moment, Alan. It's a great night for you, and to celebrate now, I suppose it's going to be long into the night, isn't it?
Yeah, there's a party at the South Brook. See you there.
Alan Rossiter, ladies and gentlemen. So the riders are going to come around amongst you as they make their way back to the pits. All that remains for me to say is thank you so much for all turning up tonight. It's been a pleasure to be back for you for the semi-final final. Have a great winter, and we look forward to seeing all of you in spring 2020. Good night, God bless, ladies and gentlemen. All the best.
Going to be on it tonight, eh?
Do that again, Roscoe, this way though.
Pick one for yourself.
Maybe look like some rubbish and I just get lucky sometimes, right? Again,
absolutely brilliant scenes, weren't they? Longer may they live in the memory, and they certainly will. Adam and Jason, what a potent pairing that has been. Absolutely superb for Swindon, as have all seven members of the side, of course, and also not forgetting the early season signings as well, of course David Bellagio and also Zach Voigtnek and James Shanes as well, also railroad for the Robins. But well, these riders are going to get to, I think they're going to be a press conference at some stage, and they will make their way there. Some of the fans, well, they're starting to make their way home now. They've had an exceptional night this evening, because obviously the Ipswich fans, I think they would have realised that perhaps the game was up after the first leg on Tuesday, but they came here in pretty good numbers, and they would have seen their side finish runners-up in the Premiership. All smiles, as you can see. And well, Lee Keel will be there just checking in the riders off into the throng. And there's going to be plenty of backslapping, as you would expect. It's a great, great scenes here at the Abbey Stadium. It's in many great sights over the years. Of course, it's been in many years. I think 1948 was the first year when it was up, when Speedway first took place here at the Abbey. Seen some great nights, but well, this compares it with every single one of the best ones, that without a doubt. As the riders make their way through the crowd, and well, they've still got Roscoe, he's still got that beaming smile on his face, hasn't he? As the riders, well, there they come, there's Jason Dahl there, he's not going to let go of that trophy, is he? And well, also, of course, plenty of fans that, well, got autographs. You don't see many autographs these days, of course, it's mainly the selfies, but Jason more than happy to add his signature to those goggles. And well, he's going up to that press conference now. Oh, that, there's the selfie. We thought we might see one. Indeed, we have. As Jason, well, he's very slowly getting, he's what, making his way up the stairs. And well, that does just about wrap it up from the Abbey Stadium, not only for tonight, but also for the 2019 season. Don't forget, of course, the Swindon Highlights DVD, which will be out shortly. And also, we'll be bringing the action from the dinner and dance as well. That promises to be a great occasion, just as tonight has been. Well done to Jason, well done to the Robins. A fantastic achievement, the 2019 Premiership Champions.